This is XB-1 history's first independently developed supersonic jet. Every feature of this airplane has been optimized for high-speed performance, and everything we've learned from the aircraft has directly informed the design and development of our Overture passenger airliner. Its fuselage is designed for speed minimizing drag and supersonic performance. Its carbon composite airframe retains its rigidity and strength even under the temperatures and pressures of high-speed flight. XB-1 Delta Wing balances low-speed performance for takeoff and landing with high-speed efficiency. Three JE5 engines designed by General Electric propel it to breakthrough supersonic speeds. Its ergonomic cockpit was designed with our test pilots in the loop, with hundreds of hours of human factors analysis and usability testing. Its nose, where the air first meets the airplane, has a refined shape to generate the precise vortex flow to ensure stability across a wide range of air speeds. Boom Supersonic Jet moves toward debut flight for XB-1. Boom Technologies' faster-than-sound XB-1 jet has completed key milestones on the way to its historic first flight. A new supersonic jet has completed further milestones on the runway toward its debut faster-than-sound flight. The recent progress made toward XB-1's first flight reflects the team's collective efforts to build and safely fly the world's first independently developed supersonic jet. The plane is designed to fly at Mach 2.2, 2.2 times the speed of sound, or around 1,700 miles per hour. The first flight will occur over the Mojave Desert in the same patch of airspace where, in October 1947, Chuck Yeager first broke the sound barrier in the Bell X-1 experimental aircraft. The XB-1 also recently took another important step toward its first flight, receiving an experimental airworthiness certificate from the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration after a detailed aircraft inspection. Additionally, authorities have approved the use of airspace over the Mojave Desert by XB-1, and Boom has letters of authorization to allow Chief Test Pilot Bill Doc Shoemaker and Test Pilot Tristan Geppetto Brandenburg to fly the supersonic jet during the test flight. Both Boom test pilots have completed hundreds of hours in a simulator and a T-38 trainer jet to help them train for the flight. According to Boom, the company brought together 60 years of airplane technology, including advancements in carbon fiber composites and advanced avionics, to create the carbon composite body and titanium fuselage of the XB-1. The supersonic aircraft features a modified delta wing, a wing pairing in the form of a triangle, named for its resemblance to the uppercase Greek letter delta. Boom says that the XB-1 possesses three General Electric J85 engines that provide the jet with a combined thrust of up to 12,300 pounds. It's fitting that XB-1 is now progressing toward first flight at the Mojave Air and Spaceport, home to more than 50 first flights and other significant aviation events, Shoemaker said. I'm looking forward to flying XB-1 here, building on the achievements of other talented engineers and pilots who inspire us every day to make supersonic travel mainstream. Overtures toward commercial supersonic flight. The XB-1 represents a milestone in the development of Boom's planned commercial airliner called Overture, which Stahl said could soon make supersonic flight mainstream. Provided all goes well with XB-1 testing, Boom aims to roll out the Overture craft in 2026, with the first flight of the aircraft planned for no sooner than 2027. Overture will be a successor to the last commercial supersonic aircraft, the Concorde, which operated between 1969 and 2003. Concorde was grounded due to rising operating costs and falling ticket sales. That latter problem resulted primarily from two factors: the crash of Air France Flight 4590 in 2000, which killed all 109 passengers and crew, as well as four people on the ground, and a general downturn in the aviation industry in late 2001 following the September 11 attack on the World Trade Center. Concorde's last supersonic passenger flight was on October 24, 2003, according to History.com, when it flew at twice the speed of sound between John F. Kennedy International Airport in New York and Heathrow Airport in London, carrying 100 passengers. Thanks for watching.